Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's your bro here, and in this video I'm going to teach you guys how we can include audio on our web pages using HTML. Let's get into it. Now, before we begin, if you want to follow along, you can download an MP3 audio file, or you can find one on your computer and use that, and place it in the same folder that contains the HTML document that you plan on working with. Just so you're aware, HTML5 only supports these audio files: MP3, WAV, and OGG. And WAV and OGG don't work on all different web browsers, but MP3 does, so you really can't go wrong with using MP3 audio files. If you need an MP3 audio file, YouTube does have a free audio library that contains music as well as sound effects. You can use whatever you want for your projects, websites, videos, whatever you need. So, you know, you can browse through here and pick something that you like. I just so happened to find this song called Bro Time, so let's give it a listen. I like it mostly because of the title, and if you want to download it, just go to the right and click download. I'll include a link for this audio library in the description down below. Here's that audio file I downloaded. It's within the same folder that contains the HTML document that I plan on using. If you want to place this somewhere else, feel free to do so. I'll show you how you can include the file path when we start to link our audio files to our web pages. If you're all set, let's begin. The first step is that we need a pair of audio tags, and make sure to put this within the body of your HTML document. We're going to type audio. We need an opening tag as well as a closing tag. Let's save this and refresh the page. Nothing appears to happen quite yet. The next step is that within the opening audio tag, let's put the word controls and see what this does. So let's save, reload, and we now have this little control bar for our audio. It doesn't appear to do anything quite yet. Everything's disabled. There's a play button, some timestamps, and a volume bar. We need to list an audio file as a source for this. So between the audio tags, we're going to use the source tag. And within the source tag, we're going to type this: SRC equals double quotes. And then within the double quotes, type in the name of the audio file that you want to link to this. For me, I was using that title, brotime.mp3. Let's save this, reload, and look at that. Everything's filled in and no longer disabled. So let's play this and give it a listen. Yep, everything seems fine. So there's also a volume bar too, where you can mess with the sound. You can also mute it too, and you can see that it's still playing. Not all versions of web browsers support audio, so it's good to write a message within your audio tag that displays a message such as, "Your browser doesn't support audio." In case somebody's browser doesn't support audio, it's not going to display the audio controls or play the audio. It's just going to display this message that lets the user know that's viewing your web page that basically their browser doesn't support audio. Here's a scenario. Let's say that the audio file you want to use is someplace else on your computer or in a different location besides the same folder that contains your HTML document. For example, I moved that audio file to my desktop. Since we moved that audio file, it's no longer within that same folder that contains this HTML document, and it can no longer link this as a source. So we need to list the file path for where the audio file is located before the file name. So for me, it's currently on my desktop. So what I'm going to have to do, since this is in a different folder, I need to list the file path before this audio file name. So let's save this and see if it works now. And yes, it does. Here's a few tricks you can do with audio in HTML. Now, if we were to fast forward to the very end of this song, you will notice that it actually stops once the song is complete, right? In the opening audio tag, if we use the keyword loop within it, save this and then reload, this song, this audio file, is going to loop through continuously. Let's try it out. So I'm just going to fast forward. Bear with me. Yeah, and it started over again. Another option for our audio is that we can begin audio automatically being muted, so we can use the muted keyword within the opening audio tag. If we were to reload this page, the volume is already muted by default. And even if we were to hit the play button, it's still going to be muted. Lastly for this topic, I'm going to teach you guys about autoplay. Now, I would actually not recommend using autoplay because if somebody visits your webpage and they're in a quiet or private location, and then all of a sudden the webpage that they're on just starts blasting audio or music, they're going to become fairly irritated. But I'm going to teach you guys how to do so anyways. Now, within the opening audio tag, just write the word autoplay within here. Now the audio will play regardless if the user wants it to or not. Autoplay doesn't work for some web browsers as well as mobile devices. If I were to save this and reload, I'm actually using Google Chrome. It doesn't appear to work on Google Chrome, so results may vary with autoplay. So what I'm going to do is open this HTML document with our old friend Internet Explorer. And I do have to allow blocked content. So you can see that this autoplayed as soon as we got to this webpage. I'm going to refresh this. And it just keeps on autoplaying. And if you want to be really annoying, just take out the controls for the audio, then you end up with some nice background music that the user cannot stop. Allow blocked content. Yep, and the user cannot stop this normally. Well, that's the basics of using audio in HTML. If you're looking for practice or a project to work on, I have an idea. Let's create perhaps some sort of music website like iTunes, but it's going to be the poor man's version of iTunes. In fact, I'm going to call it MeTunes. If you want to follow along with this, download or locate a few audio files and put them in the same folder as your HTML document or someplace else, but remember what the file path to get there was. And if you need some MP3 files to download, you can always go to YouTube's audio library, and here you have free music and sound effects that you can use. Here are the names of the audio files that I'm using. They're all MP3, City Nightlights, Bro Time, Block Party, and Beat Your Competition. If you have a few audio files picked out, you're ready to start then. So you can either clear out the document you're currently working on or start a new project. Let's create a title for this webpage, and this will be called MeTunes. It's the generic brand of iTunes. So I'm just going to type in MeTunes and use an H1 heading for this. Alright, that's decent enough. I'm going to use a break line tag just so we can move down a line. Now, what I think I'll do is that I will include the song title before the actual controls for the audio player. So this first song that I'm going to be using is Bro Time. Alright, and then I want the controls for the audio player to come right after this. So after my text, I'm going to use a pair of audio tags. So I want an opening audio tag and a closing audio tag. And I'm going to write the word controls within the opening audio tag. I think I'll move down a line after the title. Okay, I like that better. Alright, now we need to use the source tag between the audio tags, and we need to list the source. So we'll say src equals double quotes, and then we need to place the name of the audio file that we want to use here. So for me, I was using bro_time.mp3. And then just in case somebody's web browser doesn't support audio, we should probably leave a message that says, your browser doesn't support audio. Let's see if this first one works. Alright, that's good enough. So I'm going to organize this a little bit, and let's repeat the same process for each of these songs. So what I'm going to do is copy this and paste it, and then make a few changes. But I should probably add a break line after this, just to give us some room. Alright, so the next song that I plan on using is Block Party. So I'll create a title. Block Party. And this was block_party.mp3. It's basically the same thing as what we did up here. Alright, so here's our second song. Good enough. All right, same process as what we did before. So I'm going to copy this, paste it, and the next song was called City Nightlights. And the source is citynightlights.mp3. Except for me, they were underscore between here. Here's the next song. Okay, let's add just one more, but you get the idea here. And the last song was called Beat Your Competition. So I'm going to change the title. And we need to list that audio file as the source. So beat underscore your underscore competition. Okay, this is the last song then. All right, good enough. But yeah, that is the generic brand of iTunes that we just made called MeTunes. It could use some work, but we're on our way. But yeah, that is everything you need to know to get started working with audio files in HTML. Hey you, if you enjoyed this lesson, then you can help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.